Maureen Dowd, it's great to have you. Thoroughly enjoyed the book, and it makes a point. It is filled with columns and work of yours only about these two. That's how much you've written about Clinton, the Clintons, and Donald Trump.
Yes, but it also has a long essay about the Bush family, whom I've covered for 30 years. And also, I started covering on the national stage Obama and Biden, so all of the cast of characters at this crazy dinner party I started with.
I've gotten so many things wrong, as Donald Trump likes to remind people, about this cycle. What have you gotten wrong that stands out?
Oh, wow. I don't know. You tell me. I don't know.
Maybe it's all subjective. Donald Trump listens to you. You know, when you've interviewed Don, and you point this out in so many columns, that when you raise with him concerns or questions, it seems like he's interested to know what Maureen Dowd is thinking.
Well, listens to me, I think, is a bit strong. You know, I picture Kellyanne Conway like a lion tamer trying to keep Donald Trump on his stool. But no, I have confronted him with many different things that seemed wrong to me. For instance, I asked him, I told him that it was wrong that there was violence being incited at his rallies and that reporters were getting roughed up. And he paused, you're right, he did listen, but then he disagreed and said he thought the violence added a frisson of excitement. And, you know, I said, how can you criticize Bill Clinton for infidelities? You're making that part of the campaign and maybe in the upcoming debates, when you had one of the most famous infidelity scandals in New York history, the Marla Maples best sex I've ever had, New York Post headline. And he said, well, I wasn't the president. So he always has some glib answer. He did not listen to me, but listen to my sister, who has an essay in the book. She's like you. Sometimes she's a Republican and sometimes she's not. But I told him, he said, is your sister still voting for me? And I said, no, because you retweeted this unflattering picture of Heidi Cruz, and that was really wrong. And he tried to say it wasn't that unflattering. And I said, yes, it was. Why don't you just apologize? And he thought about it for a minute, and he apologized. So once in a while, but not really much, does he listen to me. And I'm not advising him. I'm just stating what is unacceptable behavior.
You talk about your sister, you also talk, and he writes, your brother Kevin, and something the two of us have in common is that we are both a butter knife away at the Thanksgiving Day table from Trump supporters. So how's Trump doing among your kin?
Well, you know, it's funny because I have my own little basket of deplorables, and I read all these other columnists who have to go on these anthropological Margaret Mead road trips to hunt down the exotic Trump voter and see what they're thinking. What could they possibly be thinking? And one of the columnists wrote an open letter and said he would like to actually meet a Trump voter and reason with them. And I just have to go home. You know, I hear it all. I hear all the conspiracy theories, all the Hillary Clinton complaints, and I'm sure it's the same with you, Michael.
Let me address Hillary, because one of the Maureen Dowd columns that stands out the most for me is one that you wrote about her. Put that up on the screen while I read. All these woebegone Republicans whining that they can't rally behind their flawed candidate is crazy. The GOP angst, the gnashing and wailing and searching for last-minute substitutes and exit strategies is getting old. They already have a one percenter who will be totally fine in the Oval Office, someone they can trust to help Wall Street, boost the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, cuddle with hedge funds, secure the trade deals beloved by corporate America, seek guidance from Henry Kissinger, and hawk it up, unleashing hell on Syria and heaven knows where else. The Republicans have their candidate. It's Hillary. Explain.
Well, she's a former Goldwater girl, you know, who then became much more liberal. But Donald Trump's ideology is his ego. So the Republicans are twisting and turning to try and fit in with a platform that is basically about his ego. So when he cozies up to the evil empire, which is not at all in the tradition of Republican policy, they have to try and go along with that, which is crazy to watch. And that's just like a grade school thing of Putin complimented him, so he likes Putin. But according to Stephen Lee Myers, our reporter, You know, who has a biography of Putin, the word was mistranslated. He didn't call Trump brilliant. He called him flashy. So this whole crazy bromance with Putin may be based on a mistranslation. But so he doesn't really, he was a New York Democrat. So we have these kind of two New York Democrats running against each other. But in many ways, Hillary is, you know, she is into muscular intervention. She's a hawk. She loves Kissinger. She cozies up to Goldman Sachs and the hedge fund people, and they are her supporters. The 1% money people are supporting Hillary.
Final subject. The other column that really jumped out of the book that I remember was the Joe Biden, Bo Biden column that you wrote. And this was, it was not a deathbed scenario. I think it was a kitchen table. But the point you drove home was that Bo wanted his dad to run. Can I put that quickly up on the screen and remind people of what Maureen Dowd wrote? Bo was losing his nouns and the right side of his face was partially paralyzed, but he had a mission. He tried to make his father promise to run, arguing, continues on, that the White House should not revert to the Clintons and that the country would be better off with Biden values. Here's the question for Maureen Dowd. You think Joe regrets not having gotten into this race?
Yes, he is. Well, he has said himself, you know, he thinks about it every day. And if I were Joe Biden, I would be really angry because he would be walking straight into the White House. And that's usually the vice president has the right of first refusal, you know. But they thought that he would shoot off his mouth and have a lot of gaffes. But in the era of Trump, you know, that his gaffes would seem like nothing. And there was some Democrats the other day when Hillary had her health scare who were saying, you know, maybe she, if it got worse, maybe she would have to step aside for Biden, which would be ironic since they pushed Biden out for Hillary.
The year of voting dangerously. As I like to say, Maureen, I've never seen anything like it in my life, and I hope I never do again. Thank you so much for being here.
I agree with you, Michael. Thanks.